Hi, my name is Dr. Ramata Cisse, a professor of anatomy and physiology at Georgia Gwinnett College. Today is my birthday and my 28th wedding anniversary. So when I had my class this morning, I was talking to my students, sharing some life experiences, and they all asked me to do a video about it. I said, okay, I'll do a video after class. So it's after class and I'm gonna do a few minutes video. What I was telling you guys is that my job is to teach. And teaching, to me, is to inspire you. What is inspiration? It's to making you do more than you think you can do, basically, right? Because you have so much potential. Sometimes you don't know your own potentials. Sometimes there's nobody to get it out of you. So my job is to make sure you get the most out of your mind, out of your time, out of your energy. Now, how do you do that? The first step is to love yourself. Now, don't you just love you? Yes, you do, right? If you don't love you, nobody's gonna love you. You have to love yourself. What does loving you mean? Means? It means you know yourself. Because if you don't know you, you cannot love you. What does knowing yourself means? Know what you want, where you wanna go, where you wanna be, how you're gonna get there. Now, do you know all that? None of us know all that, but we're trying to know it. Every day we work hard to see, are we living to our fullest potential? Are we getting where we wanna get to? Are we trying our best? In that, sometimes we will meet people who will think in the opposite way, who will not share your view. But that's the beauty of life. It is not because you don't agree with people that you're against each other. Those contradictions, those opposing views are the ones that will create, that will build you up, that will make you more than you are. We talk about bone tissue, right? If you take human bone, we are built up with many different cells that do different things. Let's take the osteoblast and the osteoclast. One osteoblast build the bone and the osteoclast break the bone. Now, they do opposite things, but for the body to be balanced, they have to work with each other. They cannot just think that, hey, you build, I break, we are opposite. The building and blocking is the one that make the world what it is. Why do you break bones? Of course, you have to release calcium and the other minerals to provide your blood with enough of those things. Why do you build it? If you have too much of those, you have to preserve it, reserve it in your bone so that you can keep a balance. If you know biology, it makes you a better person. What I'm teaching you guys, I don't teach biology, I teach life. I teach you how to know you. You know the number of bones you have, 206, the number of muscles, over 600. You know how your body works. You know now the only thing you control in your life is what? Your skeletal muscle. The muscle that makes you get up in the morning, brush your teeth, do things, that's all you control. That tells you how much you're limited in what you can do for you. And that tells you how much potential you have to be who you wanna be or more than what you wanna be. So if I'm teaching you, I'm building you up to be a great human being. Not just to be a good nurse or a good doctor, a good vet, no. To be a good human being. Because when you are a good person, you will be a good anything. What is a good person? A good person who somebody who understands other people's past and present. If you're dealing with somebody, you understand that the person came from a place, had a history, had experiences that you don't know about. Those stuff in the person's past will make the person who they are. Can you go back and change that? No, you cannot. What you can do now is work based on those bases and then do what you can do with the person or about the person. That makes you more understanding of other people. Because contradiction is not a bad thing. It's just the person doesn't feel like you, doesn't think like you, doesn't see the same thing like you. It doesn't make the person a bad person. When I treat you guys, I treat you equally because you are equal. Does that mean you are the same? No, you are different. But I embrace that differences. I cherish that differences. Why? Because those differences are the ones that build me up myself. I see different students coming to the class, different attitudes, different way of thinking. That builds me up too. It makes me a better professor. It makes me a better person, okay? So I love that difference. I love those differences between you, the way you think differently. So I just did this video that I want to share with you guys so that you can know each of you represent somebody important to me to be able to take my time individually, and you as a group to take you collectively to build you up to be the best human being you can be. I'm very happy when you tell me sometimes, you know what, I'm a better person because I'm taking your class. That's what I'm looking for. It doesn't matter how great your grades are. You can have the A's and the A plus, but if you're not a good person, then those A plus are meaningless. You have to be somebody who respects other people. Now, do you respect them because they respect you? No. You respect others because you respect yourself. You love others because you love you. That's why you love yourself. You love others. So love and respect are just the base of my class teaching, right? Because there's going to be giving you the tools to be able to manage any situation. Then I tell you the most important thing. You have H2O, you have water. Drink water. If it doesn't work for you, if there's a problem, the best thing you can do for you is to grab a cup of water and drink it. Swallow the water, move in your chair, get ready, and go on. Take it positive. So I just want to let you know how passionate I am about everything that I'm doing, because I'm really passionate about it. I believe that, you know, things have to be with fun. I don't want to teach with some kind of, you know, stressful situation or anything like that. I'm very happy, and I'm happy that you guys are happy in my class, right? So also, I set for everybody a clear vision. I want you to see what you want to be, what you want to do, how you want to get there. Now, do you know specifically? No, you don't know. But everybody has a calling. You have a meaning to your life. You have something you want to be, something you want to contribute to. You look for it. Do you find it right away? No, it takes time. I'm just a little part of that to make you find yourself. If you're confused, that's good. I told you guys I had a student who came to class late, very confused. Dr. Cisse, I'm confused. I said, oh, that's good. You are confused. That means that your brain knows something's wrong that can be fixed. Think about if you're confused, but you don't know you're confused. You'll be lost forever because you don't know you're lost. So being lost and knowing you're lost is a good thing. That means there's a road to find yourself. So be lost and find yourself, right? So I hope you guys are going to be all the great citizens that humanity will talk about forever. That is my job. I'm here for that. I want to make sure that I inspire you to be the best person. I want to thank everybody for the wishes, for the cards, for everything to make me feel very special, you know? And then to share with you that whether it is your relationship with your husband or wife or your partner or anybody, your job, anything you have in life, you have to start with two things, love and respect. You have to end with two things, love and respect. To make everything come together, you have to do one thing, no matter how complicated situations are. One thing you do is what? To drink water. If you drink water, it doesn't matter how complicated it is, you will make it happen. I would like to thank each of you for all the wishes, and hopefully you will get this message, use it every day, and try to be the best you can be every single day. And your best may not be 100, but do your best. I'd rather have the best of you than to have the more of you, right? If you give him a 90, if it's not 5% of you, I'd rather have 50, that's 80% of you. Why? Because that means you're improving, doing your best, going from 50% to 80%, okay? All right, try your best. I didn't want to do this more than 10 minutes. And I love all of you guys. Keep it up. We'll make it together slowly but surely. Let's study hard. I know ANP is not easy, but we'll make it together, okay? I'll be here for you guys. I'll support you, and we'll make it happen. Thank you very much.